where the stars shine on our youth event on this Kentucky Oaks Day of May 2011 was a great event. And I personally, from my own perspective, thought this event was very much needed, and very much needed for what? Anytime you have the opportunity to at least convey a message to youth about a purpose that they should be connected to as far as advocacy. Advocacy for what? For what kind of advocacy? In the work that I'm in, and my mantra is simple, it's a simple mantra, healing and rebirth, compassion. Some way to show them a way to not be so aggressive, but also to use their great intelligence from within to not only see the sanctity of life in the fellow youth, but also to let them know that even in challenging times and living in conditions that could just make them at some point in their life want to explode, they have the power from within to deal with those emotions. And those emotions sometimes can be kind of sorted out in a way for them to see that challenge as a benefit to them, to make them stronger towards, again, that advocacy of compassion and purpose. So this Star Shine of Our Youth Day, again on the Kentucky Oaks Day in 2011, was a phenomenal event in that it was a classroom setting that we created for the purpose of educating our youth for a better day.
How can the community tap into some of that energy that these young, the youth need? Some of them need to be directed in some positive inspiration. I see what your organization is doing. What more can we as a community do?
Well, I think it's simple. We all have certain things we like to attach ourselves to for the purpose of service. And this was about service today. It was about participating, again, in a classroom setting. Classroom setting meaning what? That anytime you can sit down and you can listen to different speakers trying to advocate a positive message to you, that is a classroom setting. That's a listener connected participation for the purpose of energizing those individuals from the community to see their role in trying to do the same thing that others are doing. And that's trying to create messages and that created energy that we are discussing right now for the purpose of creating a better habitable community for our people, our elderly, our youth, our young, and not only that, adults alike. For them to understand that the only way you create peace and an environment of peace, you have to participate in the process. So back to your question, Doctor, about what can the community do? All they have to do is what they've been doing at some level. Keep being good advocates in that arena of creating peace as a conversation, compassion as a conversation, and purpose as a conversation.
In the community.